Hello loves, Send out here coming at you with another video, and in this video we are going to talk all about high porosity hair. This video is going to come in two parts. Part one is going to be my, you know, sweet and professional self, but then part two, I'm going to give you the real, and I'm going to speak in super duper layman's terms and give y'all the game on how they use high porosity hair to manipulate you up out of your coin. If you want to uncover the scientific reasoning behind high porosity hair, and then if you want to get to the real, keep watching because this one gonna be good. Over 50% of the people who identify as high porosity hair are actually low porosity to medium porosity with damaged hair shaft. Porosity is the hair shaft's ability to absorb or release moisture. Remember, hair is not the only thing that has a porosity. Your shirt has a porosity and so does your skin. High porosity hair easily absorbs and releases moisture just because of the raised cuticle. Your hair is made of dead keratin cells that are layered up, all right? And these layered up dead keratin cells have different levels of porosity. So by understanding how these levels of porosity work, you can master your hair as it pertains to what hairstyles you wear and what products and tools you use and how you use them, all right? So again, high porosity hair has a raised cuticle. I do have high porosity hair. High porosity hair happens in two ways. You could either be born naturally with high porosity hair like myself, or different practices that you do can cause the cuticle to have holes, tears, and rips within the hair shaft. Or if the hair is slightly overprocessed or right there before overprocessed, sometimes low porosity hair or medium porosity hair could be taken to high porosity hair by mistake, not on purpose. The majority of women and men identify as high porosity hair, and a lot of people actually don't have high porosity hair, and this is why products will work on your hair for a long period of time, and then out of nowhere you'll notice that the products are starting not to work the same way that they were working before. That is because most likely you think that you have high porosity hair, but you really have low porosity hair, and the products that you've been using have been working amazing for high porosity hair. But then as your hair does get healthier, as it grows out, the new hair that is coming out, that cuticle is not damaged. So by you still treating that hair that is actually low porosity hair like high porosity hair, you end up in this constant cycle of damage, right? Because then once the hair is then damaged again by you treating that low porosity hair like high porosity hair, then the hair actually really does get damaged, and you go and you run to different products to begin covering those holes and sealing the cuticle up. So high porosity hair is the porosity that is the easiest to get confused with, because you can really, really easily get the illusion that your hair is healthy when it's really, really damaged. Here on the screen are a list of different hair shaft disorders, right? And so with any of these hair shaft disorders, if you were to take some hair that had one of these hair shaft disorders and drop it and do the whole porosity test, your hair would test out as high porosity hair because you have some type of holes or splits or rips or tears within the hair shaft, like displayed here on the screen. So then your test is coming out as high porosity hair, well, in reality you actually have damaged low porosity hair. No, it's confusing, but this is why understanding the basics of the science of hair makes things really, really easy to understand. Let's talk about some of the causes of low porosity hair that are not natural or not normal. Because me, myself, I was born with high porosity hair. My hair is not damaged. And at the end of this video, if you stay around to the end, I'll just tell you my regular routine that a person with regular, healthy, high porosity hair can do, because the high porosity hair is not a bad thing. Low porosity hair is not a bad thing. But if you have naturally low porosity hair and your hair is acting as high porosity hair because it's damaged, that's when we have a problem. One of the main causes of high porosity hair, right, is heat damage. And not because flat irons are so bad, not because blow dryers are so bad, but because people don't follow the natural patterns, or people don't follow the routines that you're supposed to follow to protect the cortex of the hair, right? Because if you are, for example, letting your hair air dry, then you're not protecting the cortex properly, because you have anywhere from 100,000 to 400,000 strands. So if it's air drying, remember, all of your follicles are independent. All of your follicles are independent, all 100,000 of them. So if just because one follicle is dry doesn't mean another follicle is going to dry. They're all drying at different rates. So by you air drying your hair, by you not properly blow drying your hair, and your hair still being locked in together, especially having high porosity hair. If you air dry your high porosity hair and then go to comb it, it is the easiest and fastest way to break off your hair. All right, the fastest way to break off your hair, because with high porosity hair, our cuticles are already lifting. As you do all of those different hacks, what ends up happening is you put a whole lot of manual manipulation on a hair shaft with cuticles that are already like this. So it'll feel harder to detangle high porosity hair because the cuticles are linked together. This is why you have to have certain detangling processes that allow the cuticles to separate naturally in a very relaxed manner. Heat styling is one of the main reasons that most people get that form of damage, of heat damage, because the cuticle is not only is the cuticle wide open, right? The cuticle is full, because most people feel like high porosity hair needs more product, more moisture, and all of this stuff. So you just pack all of this product inside of the cuticle, and then you run a flat iron on top of that, so it's literally boiling it inside of the hair shaft. One good thing is that some of the heat can escape, so high porosity hair doesn't get heat damage as fast as low porosity hair does. But the way that high porosity hair does get heat damage is because you think you have to layer so many different products on top of the hair shaft, where in reality all you need is a serum. A oil is gonna coat your hair shaft, and it makes you feel like your hair shaft is healthier. I have high porosity hair too. You put oil on it and it puts this coating on the hair shaft, so you think like, oh, this is feeling silky and smooth, but in reality it's just filling up the cuticle. So then when you put heat on your hair, it's gonna like cook it and make it sizzle dizzle, right? It's gonna make it sizzle dizzle, and because the heat isn't staying inside, you're doing more aggressive passes and you're adding more and more product. So this is how high porosity hair gets damaged, not because it's too much heat remaining inside, but because there are too many products layered on top of the hair before the heat is added in the first place. All right, a lot of times most people think that you can skip certain steps, but high porosity hair is some of the easiest hair to damage because the cuticles are already wide open. So if you don't understand the science of hair and you treat low porosity hair the way that you treat high porosity hair, you'll have problems. Next up, we're going to talk about environmental pollutions. Now, environmental pollution is really, really big with high porosity hair because, again, the cuticle is wide open. So you go outside, anything dusty, rusty, dust around outside, your cuticle is wide open, and it is most likely going to receive it if the hair shaft is not protected properly. That's why one of my favorite products is Olaplex 9, because Olaplex 9 has this amazing red algae complex that actually acts as a block for environmental pollutions, the sun, heat and styling tools, and all different types. And it doesn't just protect the hair shaft from the outside of the cuticle, it actually protects the hair shaft on the inside of the cortex, where your where the protein that is making your hair curly actually lives. It lives within the cortex, not the cuticle. But this is dope because it's going to protect the cuticle and the cortex layer just in case anything does make it past the cuticle, which it won't. That will all be user error. So Olaplex 9 is something that's amazing for that. So check the link in the description box below so you can head over to my blog post and see all of my recommendations. I have quite a few recommendations. That's just one of my favorites. Remember, when we're using heat tools are causing the cuticle to raise. It needs to do that because it is temporarily changing the bonds within the hair shaft. It's temporarily changing them around. So the heat has to penetrate the cuticle. It has to penetrate the cortex, but it is your job to make sure that the products that you're putting on the hair and the way that you're prepping and preparing the hair to receive heat styling is done correctly, so that way you're not having damage. Heat damage happens when the hair is improperly prepared, because there are plenty of people who get their hair flat ironed on a regular basis. They do not have damage. They have beautiful, thick, long, healthy hair. So you just have to really be careful on how you're doing it and who you letting do it. Hair color. Now, naturally, this won't necessarily mean that your hair is damaged. If you are a person that colors their hair, then most likely you will notice a change in your porosity. For example, if your natural hair color is like dark brown, like my hair color is right now, then you decide that you want to go to like a honey blonde or a platinum blonde. Most likely, if you had low porosity hair, you will have high porosity hair or medium porosity hair once you get done getting your hair color. It is a myth though. A lot of people think that if you have a relaxer, everybody who has a relaxer automatically has high porosity hair, and that is not true, because there are a lot of people who have relaxers that still have their low porosity hair. If you are a person with extremely low porosity hair and then you get a relaxer, you'll probably still have low porosity hair or maybe medium to normal porosity. You're not necessarily going to have high. So don't think that just because you have chemical services, that means that you automatically have high porosity hair, because that is not true. And I know that for a fact. I have the data to prove it. I've had thousands of clients who have relaxers who were still low porosity. All right. So that is something that I really, really, really want you to take heed to. And there are a lot of people who could be watching this right now. It's like, oh, I'm low porosity. Well, you should do a test. You should do a detox, right? You could do so many different forms of detoxes. There are 50 million types of detoxes you can do. You check the link in my description box. I give you my Amazon list for a bunch of different detoxifiers, scalp detoxifiers. Or we can use my favorite. We all know which one my favorite is. Olaplex 4C is my favorite scalp detox, but do what you want to do, right? But that is my recommendation, or any other one that you want to use, and then test your porosity. And after you test your porosity, you may find that after you do a detoxifying treatment, you may go from low porosity hair to high porosity hair. Because if you're a person who has been layering products on your hair, or if you have used coconut oil in your hair at any point in time, coconut oil literally seals your cuticle shut permanently, unless you use the clarifying shampoo. So if you've ever done the lock method in any way, shape, or form, my love, you need to do a detoxifying treatment, then test your porosity. And if you want to know exactly how to test your porosity, just head over to my website and click the button that says free porosity test. And once you click that button, all you gotta do is give me your email. That's it. Nothing else. And I won't be emailing you like crazy. I promise I don't. Only when something is going on. And once you put in your email, it will send you your ebook immediately, right? And then go ahead, test your porosity, and then you may see, like I said, that you do have high porosity hair. That does not mean that your hair is damaged. To treat high porosity hair is very simple. For one, the first thing you want to always remember is detangling is key. And the number one thing that I see on social media, or just across social media, across YouTube, that makes my skin crawl. Like, it make me itch. I swear it make me itch. And it's when I see people detangling their hair with shampoo shampoo and conditioner. Like, it doesn't make any sense because your hair is weakest when it's wet, right? And I understand you think that the conditioner has slip, but my love, the only thing in the conditioner that is providing slip for you is the oil. That's what's providing the slip in the conditioner. Here on the screen, you'll be able to see how a conditioner is made. They take water, wax, and they oil, and then they mix a scent with it. And then most of the time, they drop a little bit of silk amino acid just for it to be a little more slippery, just for it to be slippery, just for more slip, just in case the oils that they're using aren't doing that. And if you're using an oil like rosehip oil or something like that, or hemp seed oil, you don't need any additional silk amino acid because of the level of it present in certain oils already. So when you are detangling your hair with conditioner, you, the only thing that's giving it slip is the oil. So it makes more sense for you not to break the bond, to keep your hair in the strongest state, which is when it is dry, and you can use an oil. It'll be super amazing for you to use a herbal oil to detangle your hair. And when you use that herbal oil to detangle your hair, you can if you really want to, like if you do have a scalp problems, or if you do have a scalp problems or scalp issues or anything like that, at that point, after you oil detangle your hair with the herbal oil, then you can go ahead and put a little bit on your scalp, sit under the dryer for 10 to 15 minutes, 30 minutes tops, then shampoo it out of your hair and condition your hair and keep going. But keep it very simple. Remember that with high porosity hair, your hair is already like this. Like your cuticles are locked. Like this is a hair strand and this is a hair strand. My fingers are the cuticles. So look at, my fingers are the cuticles. So at one time, like your hair shaft is like this. So by you just randomly wetting it, like, when it's tangled but dry, it's like this and standing up. But then when it's tangled and wet, the second you wet it, it collapses. So it's collapsing and it's locked on to each other like this, right? So think of dry hair, and then you add an oil that can slip past each other. The strands can slip past each other. But when they can slip past each other very easy when you just add an oil, when your hair is still strong and alert when it is dry. But then when you wet it, you collapse it, and then you grab a comb and the conditioner and pull it apart. This is why there's so much hair in the comb and the brush whenever you guys finish combing your hair, because you collapse the hair shaft and now they're holding on to each other like this. And so whenever it breaks apart, it's not because they slip, it's because it breaks. It's because it breaks apart. And then that's the hair that you see in the brush. So if you just go ahead and skip over wetting the hair and going ahead and using an herbal oil, or using like a almond oil or hemp seed oil is my favorite because it has the slip that you guys like, and it's a zero on the comedogenic scale, so it will not block the follicle, it will not block the scalp. Head over to Guru VIP, you guys learn how to make 5 glycerides, and this week you'll be learning how I'm using these glycerides to make the new products that I have coming to you guys. Guru VIP, they have, not only do they have the inside scoop on what I'm doing behind the scenes, they're like low-key making the products with me, right? They know exactly what is in the products that are going to be coming straight to you guys' door, all right? But yeah. High porosity hair between the two is the one that you can go ahead and have protein with. Now, even though because you have high porosity hair does not mean that you have to do 50 million kabillion protein treatments. When we are talking about high porosity hair, you want to make sure that you are doing bond reconstructive treatments because your cuticle is open most of the time. So you do have more chances chances of breakage. There are more chances of your hair to get damaged because the hair shaft is open. So, right? Or something like, once again, like Olaplex 8 is really, really good for low porosity hair and high porosity hair. But I love it, especially for my high porosity hair, because what it does, it really, really, really protects my hair and it really helps my cuticle to lay flat. It does not lock my cuticle, but it helps me to let my cuticle know that I'm the boss and it needs to do whatever I tell it to do. And the patterns that I follow teach my cuticle to lay flat, right? So you want to make sure that your hair is always clean. Co-washing is the last thing that a person with high porosity hair needs to do. I want you to remember, even though like people like to say, oh, let your sebum accumulate and let it flow down the hair shaft, sebum is not a oily substance. It is a waxy substance. Google it, right? You can say an oil has to drip its way down the hair shaft, but sebum is not dripping its way down the hair shaft. Sebum is a waxy substance, so you have to comb your hair to get it down. It's a wax. It's not going to flow down by itself. It's a waxy substance that binds to the hair shaft. You have to comb it. This is why you can't block the follicle, because it's a waxy substance. It needs the space to maneuver, and if something's blocking it, it's gonna beat the waxy substance. The waxy substance is going to stick to each other, right? So that's why you want to really be careful of what you're putting in your hair, and you want to make sure that you have a set pattern that you're sticking to. Because even though it may seem like high porosity hair, it's just so bad and it's so damaging. It's not that. It's just that you have to follow certain patterns whenever you are doing your hair, whenever you are prepping your hair to be done. You can't just go get a heat tool and put it to your hair if you have high porosity hair, because your cuticle is wide open and is going to accept anything that you throw at it. So you have to be careful. Now, this was part one. And I kept this as PG as I can. But part two is the one that you don't necessarily want to watch if you're sensitive, because I'm about to be straight no chaser. In part two, I'm going to let you know how they use your low porosity hair. There may not even be low porosity hair. It may just be damaged. All right. I'm going to show you in this video how they use that to get all of your money, and how they're still using it on a regular basis, and how you can stop getting played just simply learning the science of hair. So let's talk about it.